Hi friends, we started from collection of data and types of data. Then we learnt a way to organize that data using a simple technique known as tally marks. We also learnt how we can divide this data in two ways, that is grouped data and ungrouped data. For the grouped data, we also learnt about the inclusive class and the exclusive class. This is what we learnt in our previous session. What else can we do with a data? Have a look at these images. Can we have some meaningful conclusions just by looking at the data? The answer is yes. We can take the organized data and make it even better for a person to read. Let's learn this using a very simple example. In your class, you wanted to know which fruit is liked the most. You had few options like apple, mango, banana, kiwi, etc. Now you went and asked the friends and classmates about the fruits that they liked and you finally received the data that you want. Now do you remember what does this type of data collection is called? Yes, it is called primary data collection. Now this looks very shabby and we can organize this data in the form of a table. Now if someone wishes to know which fruit is liked the most, so looking at this table, it is not really something that can be said at an instant. It will take one to have an accurate look at the table, then get an answer. But if you would show an image like this, now can you tell which the most liked fruit is? How much time it took for you to reach an answer? Very less, right, comparatively? So this is the kind of effect an image has as compared to a table. It conveys the meaning behind a concept in a very simple and easy way. It is wisely said that a picture is worth thousands of words. And moreover, it is easier to compare between things when they are represented in a pictorial form. So today, we will deal with pictorial representation of data. The one we saw just now was through pie chart. The other way is known as a bar diagram. Now exactly, what is a bar diagram? As the name suggests, it definitely involves diagram where we have to show a relation between two variable quantities. Like in this case, we have listed two variables, that is the fruits and the number of students. The next thing to notice is bar. Now, a bar in mathematics is something that is lengthy, like a shape of a rectangle if it is 2D or cuboidal or cylindrical if it is 3D. So a bar diagram involves representing two variables in a data in the form of a bar. Things to remember about a bar diagram is, first, the bars are of uniform width with equal spacing between each other. Second, on the x-axis, we plot independent variables like the fruits, colors, months, etc. The height of the bar is determined by the values of the variable. Now let's plot a bar diagram using the data that you guys just collected from your class. Now on the horizontal bar, we will write the fruits and on the vertical bar, we will have the number of students. Now we have 6 fruits in total. Now, number of students liking apple is 6, mango is 26, banana is 10, kiwi is 18, pineapple is 10 and orange is 15. And here we go, our bar diagram is ready. It is very important to mention a proper scale too. On y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 2 students. Mentioning a proper scale is also important because it helps in reading the bar diagram. On the x-axis, we have independent variables and hence no scale is required. Now this is known as a simple bar diagram. Wasn't this simple to plot? But suppose if you have a data like a company produces 2 types of chocolates, fruit chocolate and milk chocolate. Now can you plot this data in a simple bar diagram? No, right? You may either need 2 bar diagrams or a new type of bar diagram. So let's see few types of bar diagrams. There are 4 different types. We just saw simple bar diagram. The next is joint bar diagram. Now in here we will make the bars adjacent to each other and the bars will be joint and hence the name. Now we can plot this data in the form of a joint bar diagram. For example, for the year 2013, production of fruit chocolate is 100 kg and milk chocolate is 150 kg. And and we will plot the rest also similarly. Well, here we also have to mention in the scale about the colors or marking that we have to show the different types of chocolates. Well, the same data can also be represented in a single bar, and that same bar can be divided. Now this is known as a subdivided bar diagram. Here it is important to represent the region by marking them properly. One advantage of subdivided bar diagram is that you can see the total production of a particular year in just one bar, and you can check in which year the production was the most. Well, at times we need data in the form of percentage for better comparison. In that case, first we will have to convert the frequencies in the form of percentages. Now, how can we do that? Let's take the year 2013. Fruit chocolate was produced 100 kg and milk chocolate was produced 150 kg. So the total chocolate produced is 250 kg for the year 2013. Here we need to calculate what percent of 250 is fruit chocolate. So we divide 100 by 250 and multiply it by 100 to get a percentage. So fruit chocolate is 40%. So the milk chocolate will automatically come to 60%. Similarly, we can calculate this for the other years too. Now we can plot this data in the form of a subdivided bar diagram. But since the values are in the percentage, this is called as a percentage bar diagram. Well, making a bar diagram is easy, and so is reading a bar diagram. Have a look at this figure and try to answer these questions. And yes, don't forget to comment down your answers. We would like to know how you are doing. Now, what exactly is the use of bar graph? A bar diagram makes it easy to compare sets of data between different groups at a glance. And bar charts can also show big changes in a data over a time. Now, while studying bar diagram and pie chart, we saw that there are numbers which we plot, and against that numbers we write particular category like fruits, household expenses, etc. This type of data is called as categorical data, and categorical data is plotted on pie charts and bar diagram. But then there is data where there are no categories but numbers or class or range of data against the frequencies. This type of data is called as quantitative data, and quantitative data is represented in graphical form. Well, we'll have a look at the representation of graphical form in our next session. I hope you guys have enjoyed this session. Don't forget to hit the like button, and yes, and subscribe to our channel if you already haven't. And for further updates, don't forget to hit the bell icon. Till then, keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.